folks, these sofas are available to you. You can have a seat, okay?
Celebrate in this life of Dannie, Beth, some people call her Dannie. We never knew about Dannie Beth. That was all there was to it. But let me just share some things with you today about her life, and we're here to celebrate that life together. Dannie Beth Prock was born March 2nd, 1953, to William Bill Joby Prock in Pampa. She passed away on March the 20th of this year in Amarillo at the age of 70 years and 18 days. Just had a birthday, didn't she? So many hours were spent playing model cars with her best friend, Ron Love, under the old elm tree. Ron's here, right back there. He said, I think that was the biggest tree in Pampa. Big tree. Had a lot of leaves to rake whenever it froze. She graduated from Pampa High School in 1971. And while in high school and college, she and her family would go to Cabot Ranch near Stonewall and fish and relax. A lot of people from Cabot went to Stonewall. Right, Chris? A lot of people. Dannie graduated from West Texas State University in 1975. She taught 1 year in Allenby, teaching 4th through 8th grades. I can't imagine teaching 4, 5, 6, 7, 5 grades. Teachers, what do you think? No. Following, she got a wonderful teaching job at Baker Elementary here in Pampa. Several teachers are here that were at Baker at that time. She taught 1st grade most of that time with learning disabilities. And after Baker closed, she went to Travis Elementary and also in Pampa. Amy told me that how they figured that out when Baker closed is all of those teachers requested where they would like to go teach. And they kind of scattered them where they felt like they were going to be to the best teacher and the grade level that they were teaching as well. And so Dannie Beth went to Travis and taught there. She loved her students just as if they were her own kids. And I saw that many, many times. Had a wonderful giving spirit, heart, and always wanted to help others. She retired in 2008, and she went with her parents as they built a house in Timber Creek Canyon. It's between Amarillo and Canyon. Where she loved to watch and care for wildlife. I don't know if any of you were on Facebook with her, but oh my gosh, she would feed those deer, anything that came up. I think she probably had a name. They were very, very special to her. Some of her friends were childhood Ron Love and Chris House and family. Chris is here today. We'll talk a little bit more right up here. He and his daughter and his wife. Some of her friends were childhood friends, like I said, Ron and Chris, Julie Danielson, Bonnie Cantor, all of Amarillo, and then the cousin Gene Johnson of Canyon, plus Janie Prock McPeak of Carmen Amarillo, California, Jeannie Prock Carden of Winchester, Virginia, and Joyce Prock Tuttle of Belton. And I knew those three girls. They, her mom and dad were members of Central where we were. And Fern and Ralph Prock. So they were all friends as well as they were cousins together. She preceded in death by her parents. Like I said, I'm glad that you are here today. It's a wonderful day. The weather is beautiful, and we're just thankful for the Lord for all that He has done for us. When Dannie Beth taught at Travis, my wife was there as well. They were taught across the hall from each other, and so knew Dannie Beth real well through all of those years. But she loved first graders. She loved it and did a great, great job. We're going to hear another song, Amazing Grace. Definitely our Lord in our life is amazing. Amazing for all the things that He does for us. And it's a great, great song. So listen to it. All right.
Amazing grace.
times of deep grief. We've all been there at times in our lives. Our Lord may seem far away from us, but actually, folks, He's not. He's right there with us, close beside us. But today we can experience and we can trust His presence with us. He also gives us three precious promises that I want us to consider today in the life of Dannie Beth. So here's the first one. He promises to hear us. In the Great Commission in Matthew 28:20, he was teaching his disciples when he said to them, I am with you always, even to the end of the age. So He's with us even until the end of that age, and we're never alone. So just as Jesus did the teaching everywhere He went, there was teaching happened in the Prock family. Because you see, Dannie Beth's grandmother, Dannie Beth's mother, and Dannie Beth were all teachers. I wonder how it was when they all got together. Sharing those experiences, and what a great time I'm sure that they had together. They all taught in public school. And then Jo attended WT later in her life, and Dannie Beth did it also. And the unique thing about that is they were at WT together for 2 years. Isn't that interesting? So her mother, after she moved to Pampa and had Dannie Beth and went through all the school, then she decided to go to school. So they were together. I think that would be a really, really neat thing to do. So here's some things about a teacher. First of all, Dannie Beth chose to be a teacher. And I think God gives us abilities to do things within our life and leads us in that direction. That's what He did in Dannie Beth's life. Chose to be a teacher. She was organized because it takes only really a lot of planning and a lot of dedication to that. Thirdly, for a good teacher, it's a calling of God. He leads us where He wants us to go. He equipped her. And it says, for a good teacher, it's really what God calls us to do. Anymore, folks, God has to lead in teaching. It's not the easiest profession to be. And I think God gives us that ability to what He wants us to do and how He wants us to do it, and leads us in that direction as well. I am a teacher. A teacher is someone who leads. There's no magic here. I do not walk on water, and I do not part the sea. I just love children. And that's what it's all about, folks. We don't make waves. We don't do things that are not pleasing to God. We're there to teach the children. And that's what she did. There was prayer, because Dannie Beth wanted to really be an example in her life and in her prayer life, to let every child be what they wanted to be. And she helped him, and she directed him in that direction as well. God hears our prayers, folks. And prayer is so very important. And I think that was in her life as well. Not only He promised to hear us, but He also promises to help us. Dannie Beth knew that she needed help as she traveled through life. And I just want to share some of those family things that Dannie Beth loved, things that she participated in, things that she was involved in. But she knew she was never alone, and her Lord, it allowed her to enjoy life and a lot of things that were a part of her life. University Church of Christ in Canyon was where she attended, and she, from time to time, before COVID came, she would have the young people and the youth out at her house. They would enjoy hot dogs and games and things like that together. Also, she had the 55 plus adults, and they would have a meal together and play games and do all kinds of things. She really wanted to be involved in other people's lives. And that's what she did. It was a ministry that she had at that church. And she loved her church. She loved going to it. And I always say, we're saved to serve. And that's what she did. She knew the Lord. She was saved. But he called her to serve as well as he does all the rest of us. Dannie Beth loved Pampa. She talked about Pampa a lot. Chris shared that with me, and he traveled back and forth with her several times from Amarillo to Pampa. And a great friend, before they left Amarillo, she always had to go by McDonald's and have McDonald's breakfast. And then before they left Amarillo, Chris was telling me this. He said that she liked to eat. So when they got to Pampa, Coney Island, well, that was a favorite chocolate place. And that's where they ate. And then Divers was a must. We all like Divers. So Divers was another place that they would stop at. And then if they had time on the way home, they stopped in Panhandle. Guess where? Dairy Queen. Guess what she had? Ice cream. They make the best, don't they? Well, and then Amy would tell me stories about Dannie Beth loved wiener schnitzels in Amarillo. When they were building their house, Joe would go from here to Amarillo to check on the house and see the progression of it and see what how things were going. Well, she would always go by wiener schnitzel and she would get hot dogs and bring them home. Dannie Beth loved them. Well, one day she asked Amy and also Katie Hupp, who was another first grade teacher with them, all three of them first grade tracks, if she would like for her mother to stop at Wiener Schnitzel and get them a hot dog as well. So Amy and Katie looked at each other and said, why not? So she went by, she got four. Dannie Beth never did like chili on them. So they just had the plain hot dog. So they enjoyed that. But she wanted them to experience that same experience that she had. Ages, 6 and 4, Ron was telling me about their neighborhood on Bank Street. There was also a family named Myrtle and Dale Barnett. They lived next to them, all three of them, Ron, Dannie Beth, and the Barnetts. She couldn't say Dorothy, so she called her Bobby. And she called her Bobby for several years until she could say Dorothy. But they were all good friends. In fact, the Barnetts were, Ron said, kind of like second parents because they spent a lot of time there at their house. Great, great neighbors. Ron and Joe mentioned to Dannie Beth one day, she was riding her bike and training wheels were on it. And they said to her, Dannie Beth, if you don't get those training wheels off, then we're going to make you eat a tomato worm. How gross is that? Have you ever seen a tomato worm? It wasn't long till those wheels came off of that bike and she rode it. Oh my. Joe was making a spice birthday cake for Dannie Beth one day and she put all the stuff into it, put it in the oven, and it failed. There was something she didn't put into it. And Dannie Beth said, well, that looks like a cow patty. Well, her sense of humor was always there, always a sense of humor, always made something good out of something bad, I guess you could say. Well, she loved cars. Did you know that? Did any of you ever know she loved cars? She loved cars. She would tell Amy and Katie, she said, now, I want to tell you about this car that I saw the other day, or when the new cars would come out. She'd say, well, that's a certain year. this is how fast it will go, this is what it will do. She always, always knew. Ron said she could put a model car together quicker than he could even get it out of the box. So she loved cars. And the funny thing about it, she had a 1971 Plymouth Roadrunner in the garage. Can you imagine that? She liked the cars that went fast, too, folks. She liked to drive, and they went fast. She got into that. But I've said several times in my ministry that when God puts someone in your path, He did it for a purpose. God always does that, folks. And it depends on how we respond to that as to what happens to us in that life. He did that in her life. He did that for a purpose. He didn't do that to anyone else, but when He did it, there's two gentlemen that responded in that. I praise the Lord. Praise the Lord when that happens and people respond. Ron had been a friend with Dannie and Beth forever, little kids together. And he responded to that request of the Lord. And also God put Chris House in her life. None of that was by chance, folks. That was God's plan. When we're a child of God, His plan is always perfect. It was in Dannie Beth's life. His timing is always right. It's never behind or ahead. It's always on time. He knew her life. He already had a plan. He knew what she needed in her life. She volunteered at the food bank in Amarillo, and that's where Chris works in the financial part. That didn't happen just by circumstance. But God put Dannie Beth in Chris's life, and he responded to that need as well. And that's one thing, these two gentlemen. There's others here today the same way, but thank you for being involved in her life and responding to what God said to you and how He wanted you to be that friend with her. God promises to hear, to help, and He also promises to heal. Just as Dannie Beth made preparation for teaching all those 30 years plus, He taught her and made preparation for her in heaven. She knew the Lord in a very personal way because there was a time in her life when she asked the Lord to come in to be the Lord and Savior of her life. And she knew that when this life was over, she knew where she was going. And heaven was her final destination, was her eternity, eternal home. In Psalm 23, Dannie's life, I think, is summarized in that. We know that. I read not long ago, this 23rd Psalm is the most loved and the most quoted of any psalm or any scripture within God's Word. So let me just share it, and you can just think along with it as well. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul, and He leads me in the paths of righteousness for His name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. She felt no evil going through that valley the other day. I will fear no evil, for You are with me. Your rod and Your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. David used oil in the healing of the sheep. That's what they used. My cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And when this life is over, and this life has been good to me, but when this life on this earth is over, what are we going to do? We're going to dwell in the house of the Lord forever. That's where she is today, dwelling in the house of the Lord forever. So I think the question for us today is, do you know for sure when this life is over where you're going to dwell? Where are you going to be? John 3:16. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, coming up on Easter, folks, death, burial, and resurrection. He gave his one and only Son that whosoever believeth in him should not perish. Perish means spending eternity without the Lord, or without those even who are loved ones. Should not perish, but have everlasting life, eternal life with the Lord in heaven. So what does all that scripture mean to us? Well, sin in our life, folks, and forgiveness is there. And the only way for God to forgive that is to have him come into your life. Forgive you to be the Lord and Savior. When you do that, he does exactly what you ask him to do. And that's what Dannie Beth did. There's hope. There's hope in the Lord. There's hope in the love that he gives to us and into our life. I always like some of the old hymns because, folks, there's lots of theology in that. We talk about hope. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly, not H-O-L-Y, but W-H-O-L-L-Y, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. On Christ the solid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. Let me share what happened in Dannie Beth's life one day. God came into that home, Timber Creek Canyon, and he said to Dannie Beth, I think it's time to go to heaven. And at that very moment, folks, the angels surrounded her, escorted her into the presence of the Lord. Satan never likes it when someone goes to be with the Lord. Never likes it. That's why the angels surrounded her, to escort her and to be with her. In Ephesians chapter 2, it says that Satan is the prince of the atmosphere above the earth, where Satan and his demons move and exist. It's territory where there's danger, and the angels took care of that. She's not here today, folks. She's well, better than she's ever been. The body is here. The spirit is with the Lord. One of these days they're going to reunite. What a day that's going to be. Great. God gave us this body to live in while we're here on this earth. She's in her eternal home today with her mom, with her dad. She and her mom are just best friends. They really, really liked each other. All of those others who've gone before and know the Lord, they're in heaven. But I hope you can say with me that one of these days, we're going to meet again. And what a day of rejoicing. What a day of rejoicing that's going to be. Amen.
Amen.
And I always say, go fight, win, and we win. Great. I'm glad you're here today. Dannie Beth, if she could speak to us today, she'd say thank you. Thank you for being a friend. And thank you for being here. I'm going to pray with us, and then Clint will give us some instructions. Heavenly Father, you're so good to us. Lord, you do so many wonderful things in our life, and we just say thank you for that. I thank you for the life of Dannie Beth. Thank you, Lord, for all that she's met, all of the many, many, many children through those 30 years of teaching her, Lord, that she had a part in their lives. We can say they were her children, and Lord, she loved every one of them. Lord, we just want to say today, thank you for loving us. Thank you for caring for us. Thank you for memories that we have, those things in our life, Lord, that are going to be with us forever about her life. And so, Lord, thank you. One of these days, we're going to rejoice. We're going to see her again. And, Lord, we thank you for that. Be with us the rest of this day. All that we do, Lord, you just surround us with your love, with your strength, encouragement in our lives. And, Lord, we say once again, thank you. thank you for loving us. Be with us in all we do now. Give us safety in travel. And Lord, the days ahead of us, I pray that you just grant us peace and love and joy. All of these things we ask in our Savior's name.
Service. This does conclude the service. You friends can stay here and visit about any if you like. The funeral home and cemetery stuff will perform the burial separately. If you knew someone wanted to be a part of the service that could not, we did record the service. We will let it to our YouTube page when we get back to the funeral. You are welcome to stand up and dismiss. If you'd like to help us with Dannie's task, you're welcome to meet us out on the porch. Thank you.